स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू डायमंड ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस नीट एंड केसेट ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द सेंटर ऑफ मास। ओके, दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ रोटेशनल मोशन। ओके, टुमारो वी विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द रोटेशनल मोशन। सो टुडे क्वेश्चंस मैक्सिमम आई कवर्ड प्रीवियस मेन्स लेवल क्वेश्चंस। सो इफ यू कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन दिस मेन्स लेवल क्वेश्चंस यू कैन डू नीट क्वेश्चंस वेरी ईजीली। सो सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर। Three particles of masses 50 gram, 100 gram and 150 gram are placed at the vertices of an equilateral triangle of side 1 meter as shown the diagram given. The xy coordinate of the center of mass will be, okay, xy coordinate of the center of mass we have to find. Okay, this is the diagram they given, mass m1 50 gram, 100 gram, 150 grams. So first we have to find out the coordinate of the each particle. So mass m1 is located at the origin, so coordinates are 0, 0. Okay, so m2 here, so m2 is 1 meter away from the origin, so x coordinate is 1 and y coordinate equal to 0. For m3, so from here 0.5, distance from the origin is 0.5 and so x coordinate is 0.5 and this one is the height of the equilateral triangle root 3 by 2a is the length of the side length they given 1 meter, so into 1 means we will get the same value root 3 by 2. Like this we have to find the coordinates. This coordinate we can find easily by using this angle, otherwise right angle triangle, anyway you can find it. Okay, now we know the masses, 3 masses and coordinates of that masses, positions of that masses, and we have to find the center of mass of the xy coordinates of the center of mass. Okay, so I written here m1, m2, m3 values and m1 ka coordinates, m2 ka coordinates, m3 ka coordinates I written here. So first I am going to find the x coordinate of the center of mass. X coordinate of the center of mass is m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 by m1 plus m2 plus m3. We know this formula. Here we have the 3 particles to 3 terms. So now I substitute the values m1 50, x1 0, m2 100, x2 1, m3 150, x3 0.5. okay, I substituted here m1 plus m2 plus m3 is a 50 plus 100 plus 150. 15 into 0 is a 0, 100 into 1 is a 100, plus 150 into 0.5 is a 75. 100 plus 75, 175 in the numerator, the denominator sum of these masses 300, 175 by 300, 25 sevens and 25 12, 7 by 12 meters we will get x coordinate of the center of mass. Now same way find out the y coordinate of the center of mass. So y coordinate is m1 y1 plus m2 y2 plus m3 y3 by m1 plus m2 plus m3. M1 is the 50, y1 is the 0, m2 is the 100, y2 is the 0, m3 is the 150, y3 is the root 3 by 2 substituted, and denominator may 50 plus 100 plus 150. So now first term 50 into 0, 0, 100 into 0, 0, 150 into root 3 by 2, 75 root 3. So numerator we will get 75 root 3, and in the denominator sum of the masses 300. 75 ones to 75 fours, root 3 by 4 meters we will get. So x coordinate and y coordinate of the center of mass are, x coordinate is 7 by 12 meters and y coordinate is root 3 by 4 meters. This is the 2019 mains question. Okay, now so next by using the position vector also we can find the center of mass, second method here. So here position vector of this one we have to find r1 cap equal to the r1 power. So this is at the origin, so I am direct writing 0. So r2 equal to the, that means we have to write down, express in terms of the unit vectors position of this one. So x value is 1 along the x direction means i cap plus y j cap, y component is a 0, just I cap only I am taking. And next for this one r3 cap equal to the x component is 0.5 I cap plus root 3 by 2 j cap. Okay, now position vectors I found here. Next the position vector of the center of mass is m1 r1 plus m2 r2 plus m3 r3 by m1 plus m2 plus m3. M1 value is 50, r1 value, position vector value is a 0, something into 0 0 we will get, and m2 value is a 100. Position vector is only x component we have, that's why I cap, plus m3 value is 150 and position vector 0.5 I cap plus root 3 by 2 j cap. Okay, now simplify it. 100 I cap plus 150 into 0.5 75 I cap plus 150 into root 3 by 2 j cap means 75 root 3 j cap. The denominator sum of the masses is 300. Okay, so 100 i cap plus 75 i cap, 175 i cap by 300 and 75 root 3 j cap by 300. Separately I written I cap j cap. So now 175 300 we can write 25 7s, 25 12s, so 7 by 12 i cap plus 75 1s, so 75 4s, so 3 root 3 by 4 j cap. So here this is the x coordinate of the center of mass and this is the y coordinate of the center of mass. Same answer we will get. Any method you can choose, this one or this one, which is easy to you, that you can choose. Okay, na? This is the second method, mains 2019 question. Okay, next question, see, four particles A, B, C and D with masses MA equal to M, MB equal to 2M, MC equal to 3M, MD equal to 4M. So I written also, whatever the masses they given, MA, MB, MC, MD, are at the corners of a square, they have accelerations of equal magnitude with directions as shown. So they have the equal magnitude of the acceleration is same for four particles, but directions are different. They given in the diagram also. The acceleration of the center of mass of the particle, acceleration of the center of mass we have to find. See now, this is the diagram they given, A, B, C, D, okay, four particles, four corners of a square, A, B, C, D, okay. So now, here this is the x coordinate and this one is the y coordinate, okay. See now, this A is moving to, A particle is moving toward the left side. So acceleration is, magnitude of the acceleration is A and unit vector in this direction is the minus I cap. So now acceleration of the A particle is minus A I cap and then I come to see the B. So this particle is moving upward direction. Upward direction is nothing but the positive Y direction. So A is the magnitude of the acceleration and direction is nothing but the in the positive Y direction. Positive Y direction my unit vector is the plus j cap. So now the acceleration of the B particle is plus A j cap. A is the unit magnitude and j cap is the direction. And C is moving in the direction of the positive x direction. So A is the magnitude and unit vector in the positive x axis is the plus I cap. So we will get acceleration of the C particle is plus A I cap. Okay, and it is moving in the direction of positive x axis. Now see the D particle is moving downward direction. Downward means negative y axis. Okay, so the unit magnitude is A, unit vector is minus j cap. So now acceleration of the D particle is minus A j cap. Okay, now so we know the masses of the particles and we know the acceleration of the particles. Now we have to find the acceleration of the center of mass formula. Acceleration of the center of mass equal to ma AA plus MB, AB plus MC, AC plus MD, AD by M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4. Four particles there, that's why. So already we know this formula, okay. Now substitute the values. MA value is M. Acceleration of the A particle is minus A I cap. Plus MB value is 2M. Acceleration of B particle is AJ cap. Plus MC is a 3M. Acceleration is plus AI cap. And plus MD is a 4M. And acceleration of D particle is minus AJ cap. By M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4 means M plus 2M plus 3M plus 4M. Okay, substituted values here. Substitution completed. Next to see now. Here I cap separately I am writing, J cap separately I am writing. Once you see, M into minus AI cap means minus MA I cap and one more I cap term is there, plus 3MA I cap. Okay, 3MA I cap minus MA I cap. 2MA I cap we will get. So 2MA I cap. Next to j cap terms see now, either 2ma j cap, either plus into minus minus, minus 4ma j cap, minus 4ma j cap plus 2ma j cap we will get minus 2ma j cap. Okay, now this is the result. By m plus 2m plus 3m plus 4m equal to the 10m. Okay, in the numerator the common is the 2ma, 2ma common, so I cap minus j cap is there, I cap minus j cap by 10m. So mm will be cancelled, 2 1s and 2 5s. So A by 5 into I cap minus J cap. So A by 5 into I cap minus J cap. Option A is the right answer. In this way we have to solve the problem. See the next question, third question. The position vector of the center of mass or CM of an asymmetric uniform bar. Okay, the bar is the uniform only, this bar and this bar, this bar, this diagram given. Asymmetrically they arranged negligible area of cross section as shown in the figure. They are asking the position vector of the center of mass. Position vector of the center of mass we have to find. They given this diagram. Okay, so this is the one rod, this is the one more rod, this is the other rod. First rod ka mass is 2m, second rod ka mass is m, third rod ka mass is m. Okay, they given the distances also. Okay, now this is the L from here. Okay, now this point. So now I am redrawing this diagram same here. Okay, so this is the first rod, second rod, third rod. Okay, first rod, second rod, third rod. Three rods we have, three bars or three rods we have. So here uniform bars, that means the mass is distributed uniformly. If they give like this of regular shape objects, so then we have to assume that total mass is concentrated at one point. That point is nothing but the center of mass. So now for the first bar, the total mass is concentrated at this point, at the center of mass of this bar, and for this also at the midpoint of this bar, and for this rod also at the midpoint of this bar. Okay, so mass of this one is the 2m, they given already 2m, mass is the 2m, and next we have to find the coordinates of this center of mass of this bar. Okay, now so here they given the length also, the midpoint here is, this is the total 2l, and here this one is the l. So now from here to here, x coordinate is the l, and x coordinate is the l, and y coordinate also l. So l comma l is the coordinates of the this 2m bar, center of mass of the 2m bar. Okay, next to this bar comma second bar comma mass is m. Now we have to find the coordinates of this one. So we have to assume that total mass is concentrated at center of mass, and this center of mass ka location position we have to find. So from here to here the distance is the 2l they given, so x component is 2l. From here to here total is the l, so of midpoint means l by 2, so y component is the l by 2. So now this is the third bar, so okay, we have to assume total mass is concentrated at the uniform bars. That's why we are assuming the total mass is concentrated at the center of mass, and that center of mass is midpoint of this bar. Okay, na? So now x component from here to here, from here to here it is the 2l, so from the length of this one is the l, so half means this is the l by 2. Okay, 2l plus l by 2, 5l by 2, x coordinate is the 5l by 2, and y coordinate is the 0. So like this we have to find the coordinates. Okay, so mass, first rod ka mass is m1 equal to 2m, and first rod ka center of mass position is l comma l, second rod ka mass is m, and second rod ka position of the center of mass is 2l comma l by 2, and third rod ka mass is m, and third rod ka center of mass ka location is 5l by 2 comma 0. So we found already completed. That means if uniform bars are there, we have to assume that total mass is concentrated at one point. That point is nothing but the center of mass, and the location of the three bars ka center of mass we found. Now use the formula and find out the center of mass of this system. Okay, na? Individually we found here center of mass location. Now total system ka center of mass position we have to find. So x coordinate of this center of mass here x, y, 2 directions only. Then x coordinate of the center of mass is m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 by m1 plus m2 plus m3. Already we know m1 value is 2m, x1 is the l, m2 is the m, x2 is the 2l, m3 is the m, x3 is the 5l by 2. So I substituted all the values. Okay, in denominator m1 plus m2 plus m3, so m 2m plus m plus m substituted. Now see 2m into l, 2ml, m into 2l, 2ml, 2ml plus 2ml, 4ml. Now m into 5l by 2, 5ml by 2, by denominator may 2m plus m 4m. Now take the LCM, this one 4 into 2, 8ml plus 5ml, 13ml by 2 into 4 is there, na? So 2 into 4, 8m we will get. So mm will be cancelled, 13l by 8 we will get. X coordinate of the center of mass of this system is 13l by 8. And next y coordinate we have to find, m1 y1 plus m2 y2 plus m3 y3 by m1 plus m2 plus y m3. Substitute m1 value 2m, y1 value l, m2 value m, y2 value is l by 2, m3 value is m, y3 value is 0 by m1 plus m2 plus m3, 2m plus m plus m, 2ml, okay, 2ml plus m into l by 2, okay, 2ml plus m into l by 2, right, this term will become 0. This 2m plus m is a 4m, 2ml plus ml by 2 is there, na? Take the LCM. 2 into 2, 4, 4 plus ml, 4m, 5ml, 5ml by 2 into 4 is there, 4 into 2, 8, so 5ml by 8m, mm will be cancelled, 5l by 8. Okay, so x coordinate is 13L by 8, y coordinate is 5L by 8. Okay, now here actual x direction we consider the unit vector is I cap, and y direction we will consider the unit vector is j cap. But in the options they given, x direction mein unit vector is x cap only, and y direction mein unit vector is y cap only. So now see, now x coordinate 13L by 8 x cap plus y component is 5L by 8 y cap, 5L by 8 y cap, okay, na? That means position vector is nothing but the r bar equal to x I cap plus y j cap, but here x into I cap place mein they took x cap only, plus y into j cap place mein they took y cap only. So x coordinate, x component, how much we get? 13L by 8 x cap plus y component 5L by 8, 5L by 8 y cap. So 13L by 8 L x cap plus 58 by A is the right answer. In this way we have to solve the problem. Next, see the next question. Two blocks of masses 10 kg and 4 kg are connected by a spring of negligible mass. Okay, na? 10 kg, this diagram not given, I drawn here. 10 kg, 4 kg are connected by a spring and placed on a frictionless horizontal surface. An impulse gives a velocity of 14 meters to the heavier block. Heavier block ko given some velocity 14 meter per second in the direction of the lighter block. Lighter block this side, so in this direction they given the velocity, how much? 14 meter per second. The lighter block, the velocity of the center of mass is, velocity of the center of mass, so the velocity of this one is 14 meter per second. They didn't mention velocity of this one, so initial velocity of this one is a zero. Now velocity of the center of mass we have to find. So first see, mass of this one m1 equal to 10 kg, velocity of this one v1 equal to 14, and mass of this one m2 equal to 4 kg, velocity of this one is a 0 meter per second. Okay, so velocity of the center of mass formula we know, m1 v1 plus m2 v2 by m1 plus m2. Substitute the value, m1 value is 10, v1 value is 14, plus m2 value is 4, v2 value is 0 by m1 plus m2, 10 plus 4, okay, 10 into 14, 140, plus 4 into 0, 0, okay, 10 plus 4, 14, 140 by 14 is 10 meter per second, okay, 10 meter per second. This is also previous year mains question. This type of questions we can expect in the NEET. Okay, so next question is, two particles A and B initially at rest, okay, move toward each other by mutual force of attraction. By mutual force of attraction means there is no external forces acting. So net force acting on this one, net force, external force acting on this one equal to the zero. Net force not acting, and the mutual force is acting means net force acting on the system equal to the zero. Okay, so at the instant when the speed of A is V and the speed of B is 2V, the speed of the center of mass of the system is. So this data, don't consider this one to confuse us. They will give initially the particles are rest means initially the center of mass is in the rest position. Initially the center of mass in the rest position. Here external forces are not acting, only internal forces are acting. Due to the internal forces, the position of the center of mass not changes. Okay, na? So here initially the center of mass is in the rest position, finally also the center of mass is in the rest position only. To confuse us, they given the velocity of A, velocity of B they given. That means initially the momentum equal to zero, finally the momentum of the A is cancelled by the momentum of the B, and the center of mass is in the rest position only. So momentum will be conserved. So small thing you have to remember here, what is that thing means? Initially the center of mass is in the rest position, and those are moving due to the mutual force of attraction. Mutual force of attraction is nothing but the internal force. Due to the internal force, center of mass position not changes. So finally also center of mass position is in the rest only. So center of mass, the speed of the center of mass is the zero. Initially zero, finally also zero. Remember. The next question, sixth question, a uniform rectangular thin sheet ABCD of mass M has length A and breadth B as shown in the figure. Okay. This is the diagram they given. So this is the thin sheet A, B, C, D. Mass of this one is the M, capital M. So okay, length. Okay, length is the A and breadth is the B. In the shaded portion, HBGO. HBGO. This is the shaded portion. Is cut off. This part is removed. The coordinate of the center of mass of the remaining portion will be. this is the remaining portion. What is the center of mass? Okay, they are asking. Okay, first see now here, this is the thin sheet, okay, plane. So for the plane, the mass is distributed throughout the plane. So then the surface mass distribution, from that one we will get the dm equal to sigma da. From this we can say that mass is directly proportional to the area. Okay, remember that one. Okay, both are the same. This cutted part also have the same density, this one also have the same density. Now density is the constant now here. So now m is directly proportional to a. Remember this case, we can solve very easily now. So before cutting this one, mass of this one is the m. Okay, so area of this one equal to the a1 equal to length is the a, breadth is the b. So area of the rectangular sheet before cutting this part is nothing but the area equal to a into b ab. Okay, and next, before cutting this part, where the center of mass located, this is the rectangular regular shape, the center of mass should be center of this rectangular sheet at this center. So the center, what is this one means, this total length is the L, from ear to ear is the, sorry, this total length is the A, and from ear to ear length is the A by 2, so x coordinate is A by 2, comma, and the next y coordinate, total is the B, from ear to ear it is the B by 2, okay, this is the B by 2, already I written here, A by 2, comma, B by 2. So I written here, the center of, coordinates of the center of mass of the initial rectangular sheet ki, A by 2 comma B by 2. Okay, now see the cutting portion. Okay, this portion is removed from this sheet. So this portion ka mass we have to find. So mass is directly proportional to area, na? So if you find area, that's all. So area we have to find. Okay, what is the length of from here to here, and what is the length of from here to here? Total length is a, na? So from here to here, this is nothing but the a by 2. Total breadth is b, na? From here to here, breadth is the b by 2. Okay, now area is nothing but the length into breadth, a by 2 into b by 2. Okay, a by 2 into b by 2, that will get ab by 4. So removed portion ka area is ab by 4, and removed portion ka, so that means this removed portion is there, na? For this one we have to find the center of mass, location of the center of mass. Suppose this is there. Now this is also regular shape only. For this one, we have the center of mass is at the center. Okay, this point we have to find. So see now, from here to here, this is the A. From here to here, this is the A by 2, and the next half of that one. Okay, here to here is A. From here to here, it is the A by 4. So now origin to this distance is nothing but A by 2 plus A by 4. Okay, a by 2 plus a by 4 is nothing but 3a by 4. Okay, this is nothing but the 3a by 4 x coordinate. Y coordinate we have to see now. So from here to here it is a b, from here to here it is a b by 2, so midpoint now. So from here, okay, this is a b, from here to here this is the b by 4. Okay, total is a b, half is the b by 2, again half is the b by 2, may half b by 4. So b by 2 plus b by 4, 3b by 4. So from here to here is the 3b by 4. This y coordinate is 3b by 4. Okay. So removed part ka coordinates are 3a by 4 comma 3b by 4. 3a by 4 comma 3b by 4. Now we found the without cutting, with before removing, we have the area AB and center of mass ka location a by 2 comma b by 2, and removed portion ka area AB by 4, and removed portion ka coordinates with respect to the origin we are getting 3 by 4 comma 3B by 4. Okay, so now found. Now we have to find the coordinates of the center of mass, remaining portion of this. Okay, now coordinates of the center of mass of the remaining portion we have to find. So now here actually we will write center of mass equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 by m1 plus m2. Okay, but here some part is removed now. So from total, we have to subtract the removed part. Okay, so now here we have to write down m1 x1 minus m2 x2 by m1 minus m2 we have to write. But here I said mass is directly proportional to the area, na? So at the place of m we have to write the a. So m1 x1 minus m2 x2 place me a1 x1 minus a2 x2 by m1 minus m2 place me a1 minus a2. We will get it very easily. Okay, na? So a1 value is ab into x1 value is a by 2 minus a2 value is ab by 4 into x2 value is 3a by 4, 3a by 4 whole by a1 minus a2. A1 value is ab, a2 value is ab by 4 substituted. So now see, in the denominator and in numerator, either ab is there, here ab is there, either ab, either ab. So total ab will be cancelled out. So then what will we get here after taking the ab as a common? A by 2, a by 2 minus ab common, 3a by 4 into 4, 16, 3a by 16. Next here ab cancelled out. So 1 minus 1 by 4, 1 minus 1 by 4 is nothing but 3 by 4, 3 by 4. And next here, 2, 16 ka LCM is a 16 and simplify it, 8a minus 3a, this 3 by 4 we can write it as 4 by 3, 8a minus 3 is a 5a by 4 1, so 4 4s we will get, 4 into 3, 2, 12. So x coordinate of the remaining, x coordinate of the center of mass of the remaining portion is 5a by 12. The same way we have to find the y coordinate of the remaining portion of the center of mass of the remaining portion. So y coordinate is a1 y1 minus a2 y2 by a1 minus y2. Already I said how to take here. So a1 value we know ab into y1 value is b by 2. A2 value we know already ab by 4 into y2 value is 3b by 4 and a1 minus a2 ab minus ab by 4. So here also ab common, ab common, ab, ab common. In the numerator, denominator ab common and cancel it, we will get b by 2 minus 3, ab cancel again, 3b by 4 into 4, 16. By here 1 minus 1 by 4, 3 by 4 we will get. So same way here also how we got, here also same way you have to do and simplify. We will get the y coordinate of center of mass of remaining portion will be 5b by 12. X coordinate is 5a by 12, y coordinate is 5b by 12. 5a by 12, 5b by 12, b is the right answer. In this way we have to solve. If you practice more and more problems, you can do this question also within the 1 minute. So somewhat lengthy we will get, but easy question we can expect from the center of mass. Next question, see now, a circular plate of uniform thickness has a diameter of 56 centimeter. A circular plate, okay, so either this is the circular plate, so diameter equal to the 56 centimeters. A circular portion of diameter 42 centimeter, from this 42 centimeter ka portion is removed, okay, from one edge of the plate as shown in the diagram, okay, in the diagram they shown. Find the position of the center of mass of the remaining portion. Remaining portion ka center of mass we have to find. Here easy way I will tell you, within 2-3 steps we can solve this one. So remember this formula. What is this formula mean? So AR into XR equal to AC into XC. AR is the area of the remaining portion. Okay, AR is the area of the remaining portion. So this XR is the center of mass of the remaining portion. Okay, center of mass ka location of the remaining portion. AC and XC is the, XC, AC is the area of the cutted portion. Okay, removed portion, area of the cutted portion. XC, remember this is the very important, XC. XC is the position, the center of mass of the removed portion from the actual portion of the center of mass. Okay, na? Remember that point. Okay, I will substitute here, see now. So area ka formula we know already, circle A equal to pi r square. Here they given the diameter, so in terms of the diameter I am writing pi d square by r. So this side area is there, this side area is there, but this side 1 by pi d square 4 we will get, this side also denominator mein 4 we will get, so 4 will be cancelled out. That's why I am writing area is directly proportional to the pi d square. Okay, now see, listen now, area of the remaining portion, area of the remaining portion how to get? So area of the initial circular plate minus area of the removed part, then we will get the remaining part ki area. So area of the initial area minus removed part ka area, then we will get the remaining part ka area. So initial diameter I am assuming as the d1 equal to 56 centimeter and removed part ka diameter is d2 equal to the 42 centimeter. So initial area is pi d1 square minus removed part ka area is pi d2 square. If I remove the removed part from the actual plate, we will get the remaining portion. Okay, this is the XR is the position of the remaining remaining position ka center of mass, this will give. And the next AC is the removed part or cutting part, cut off part ka area. So cut off part ka area pi into d square na, pi into cutting part ka area diameter is d2 equal to 42 centimeter, pi d2 square into XC. This is the important C now. So this is the actual circular plate or diameter is the 56 centimeter. So from here the radius of this one is the 28 centimeter. The center of mass of the एक्चुअल सर्कुलर प्लेट की 28 सेंटीमीटर एट 28 सेंटीमीटर एट द सेंटर इट विल लोकेटेड एट द सेंटर ओके ना सो फ्रॉम दिस एज इट इज एट द 28 सेंटीमीटर ओके ना सो दैट मीन्स दिस इज द रेगुलर शेप द सेंटर ऑफ मास इज एट द सेंटर फॉर दिस सर्कुलर प्लेट द सेंटर ऑफ मास इज हियर ओके नाउ दिस सर्कुलर पोर्शन इज रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम दिस वन सो फॉर दिस सर्कुलर पोर्शन का सेंटर ऑफ मास ऑल्सो एट द सेंटर ऑफ दिस सर्कुलर पोर्शन ओके हियर दिस इज द रिमूव्ड पोर्शन का सेंटर ऑफ मास ओके नाउ सी द डायमीटर ऑफ द एक्चुअल सर्कुलर प्लेट इज 56 सेंटीमीटर सेंटर ऑफ मास इज लोकेटेड एट द सेंटर द डिस्टेंस ऑफ द सेंटर ऑफ मास फ्रॉम दिस एज इज नथिंग बट द 28 सेंटीमीटर रेडियस ओनली ओके 28 सेंटीमीटर नेक्स्ट दिस इज द रिमूव्ड पोर्शन रिमूव्ड पोर्शन का सेंटर ऑफ मास इज एट द सेंटर ऑफ द रिमूव्ड पोर्शन ओके ना सो रिमूव्ड पोर्शन का डायमीटर के बिगन 42 सेंटीमीटर सो देन फ्रॉम दिस एज द डिस्टेंस ऑफ द सेंटर ऑफ मास इज 21 सेंटीमीटर रेडियस ओनली ओके ना नाउ दिस एक्सिस इज इंडिकेटिंग दैट द पोजिशन ऑफ द रिमूव्ड पोर्शन का सेंटर ऑफ मास फ्रॉम द एक्चुअल सेंटर ऑफ मास ओके दिस इज द रिमूव्ड पोर्शन का सेंटर ऑफ मास दिस इज द एक्चुअल सेंटर ऑफ मास नाउ द पोजिशन ऑफ दिस वन फ्रॉम दिस सेंटर ऑफ मास दिस वन सो फ्रॉम ईयर टू ईयर दिस इज द 21 फ्रॉम ईयर टू ईयर दिस इज द 28 वॉट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दिस टू 7 सेंटीमीटर सो नाउ एक्सिस इज इक्वल टू द 7 सेंटीमीटर इफ यू प्रैक्टिस मोर प्रॉब्लम्स यू विल गेट इट वेरी इजिली Okay, now I have to find the center of mass of the remaining portion. Okay, so x are equal to this. I am sending this one to this side. So, either pi is common, pi will be cancelled. We will get d2 square by d1 square minus d2 square into xc is nothing but the 7 centimeters we got. And the next, d2 value is how much? 42. So, 42 square by d1 value 52, 56, 50 square minus 42 square into 7. We can do this simplification very easily. 42 square means 42 into 42. 56 square minus 46 is 42 square, then a square minus b square. A plus b into a minus b. 56 plus 42, 98. 56 minus 42, 14 into 7. So, 7 1 so 7, 14. This will go 14 1 and 3 is 14 1 and 3, 3 into 3, 9 centimeter. The answer B is the right answer. Concentrate on these questions. See the next question. 8th question, a particle of mass m is moving with a speed 2v. Okay, na? Particle ka mass is m. Initially, it is moving with the 2v speed and collide with a mass 2m moving with the speed v in the same direction. Both are moving in the same direction. So, first particle mass is m, it is moving the 2v and second particle ka mass is 2m and it is moving with the v velocity. This is moving with the 2v velocity and collide the 2m mass particle which is moving with the v velocity in the same direction. Okay, that is the question up to that one. Okay, next, after collision, the first mass is stopped completely. Okay, now this m is there after collision, this stopped completely. So, final velocity equal to 0. And while the second one split into two particles, each of mass m, okay, now this is then split into the two equal masses, m and m, which moves at an angle 40 degree with respect to the original direction. Actually, originally these are moving in this way. And this 2m is split into the two equal masses, m and m, and making the angle 45 degree with respect to the original direction. This is the original direction with respect to this original direction, 45 degrees this m particle and 45 degree with this m particle making. The speed of each of the moving particle will be, what is the speed of these particles? We have to find. So, here this is the total system. In this system, no external force is acting, only internal forces are acting here. So, momentum will be conserved here. So, initial momentum equal to the final momentum. That means, momentum before collision equal to the momentum after collision. So, momentum before collision. So, formula we know m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equal to the m1 v1 plus m2 v2 here. Okay, na? So, that means the momentum is conserved here. Momentum before collision equal to the momentum after collision. Before collision, momentum. Okay, sum of momentum before collision equal to sum of momentum after collision. So, before collision, I am finding the momentum. So, momentum of this one is mass into velocity, m into 2v, 2mb, and mass into velocity, 2m into v, 2mb. So, before collision, the sum of momentums, 2mb plus 2mb. Okay, this before collision completed. After collision, see now. This first particle is coming to the stopping completely, it is coming to the rest. So, final velocity of this one is a 0. So, the momentum of this one is a 0. Okay. And next, the second particle is then this is split into the two equal masses m and 2m. And making the angle 45 degrees with the original direction. Okay, this one resolve into the components vertical and horizontal. So horizontal component is mass into velocity. Okay, momentum. Horizontal component of the momentum is mv dash cos 45 degrees, here mv dash sine 45 degrees, and this one also split into the components, vertical component, horizontal component. This one also mv dash cos 45 degrees, and this is the mv dash sine 45 degrees. Okay, so mv dash sine, vertical components will be cancelled out. So now in the original direction we have to take the components. Okay, same direction. So here the momentum of this particle is mv dash cos 45, and momentum of this particle also mv dash cos 45, mv dash cos 45, mv dash cos 45. Here this is split into the two equal masses, and these two equal masses are making 45 degrees the original direction. Okay, now see, 2mb plus 2mb 4mb, mv dash cos 45 plus mv dash cos 45 2mb dash cos 45 is nothing but the 1 by root 2. Okay, so now we have to find the v dash. M will be cancelled. So v dash means the speed of the each particle of each moving particle, this particle ka velocity we have to find. Okay, so v dash is the velocity of that particle. So v dash we need, m will be cancelled. So v dash equal to root 2 sin this side, so 4 root 2 sin this side, it will become denominator, here v is there. So v equal to 1, so 2 2s, 2 root 2 v. So the speed of the each particle is 2 root 2 v. Okay, like in this way we have to solve the problem. Next question, see, a shell is fired from a cannon with a velocity v at an angle theta with the horizontal direction. Okay, I'm drawing the diagram. This is the cannon and firing the bullet or particle with velocity v. Okay, and making theta angle with the horizontal direction. At the highest point in its path, it explodes into two pieces of equal mass. Here they didn't give the mass, but I am assuming that the mass of the particle is 2m, I am assuming. Okay, now at the highest point, it has the only horizontal component of the velocity v cos theta. It is moving the v velocity now. So at this case we have the velocity is v cos theta. At this highest point it split into the two parts, two equal parts. Okay, now two pieces of equal masses, this split into the two equal masses. One of pieces retraced its path to the cannon. Okay, in this direction one is going, and one more is going in this direction. Okay, then retrace its path to the cannon, and the speed of the other piece immediately after the explosion. This is retracing here with the same velocity, and next this one other particle is there, it is splitting to the two particles. So here the 2m is there. Okay, and velocity of this one is the v cos theta at the highest point. This is exploding into the two particle. One particle is retracing its path. So with same velocity v cos theta only, one more particle is going in this direction. Mass is m and velocity is the v dash. This I assumed mass is the 2m, split into the equal parts m. So it is retracing the original path. So this velocity v cos theta and this particle ka velocity are the same, v cos theta only, and other particle ka velocity we have to find. So explosion is due to the internal forces. So here center of mass position not changes, and momentum will be conserved here, initial momentum equal to the final momentum. So that means the momentum before collision equal to the momentum after collision. Before collision, what is the momentum? I assumed mass is the 2m, okay, and at the highest point velocity is v cos theta. So 2mb cos theta is the before collision. After collision, this 2m is split into the two equal parts, m and m. One particle is retracing its path, one more particle ka velocity we have to find. Okay, to keep the center of mass in the same position, so the next other particle will move opposite to this particle. Okay, now remember that point. So now this is going in the positive x direction, take positive. This is going in the negative x direction, take negative, sign convention that is. Okay, so after the collision, the momentum of the two particles. So after the collision, this is going in this direction, so opposite to this one. So mass is the m, velocity is the v cos theta, so minus mv cos theta, and this is going in the same direction only. So mass is the m, this velocity we have to find, v dash. Okay, I consider v dash. Now minus mv cos theta send this side, this will become 3mb cos theta. Okay, 2mb cos theta, this one plus mb cos theta, 3mb cos theta equal to m into v dash. m will be cancelled, v dash equal to the 3v cos theta. Okay, so the other piece ka speed after the collision, immediately after the collision is 3v cos theta, 3v cos theta. This is also mains question, okay na? Concentrate all the questions, do it, practice more, it will take the less time only, we can complete within the 1 minute, okay, thank you.